So here the next part of the discussion is, that is, we are up to the numericals in properties of liquids. So here is the problem, the first sample problem we have, that is, the vapor pressure of pure benzene at certain temperature is 0.85 bar, and a non-volatile non-electrolyte solid weighing 0.5 grams when added to 39 grams of benzene, the vapor pressure of solution now after adding the non-volatile solute is 0.845 bar, and what is the molar mass of the solid substance? This is, by looking at the problem, by reading the entire problem, you should come to a conclusion that this problem is based on the Rolle's law. That is, the concept involved is based on Rolle's law. So because it is Rolle's law, then first of all, let us collect the data. The vapor pressure of the pure benzene means here, P naught of benzene is 0.85 bar, and when a non-volatile solute of non-electrolyte solid weighing 0.5 grams means, we can take small w is equal to 0.5 grams, and when added to 39 grams of the benzene, the vapor pressure of the solution, so here capital W is equal to 39 grams of benzene. Because it is benzene, the molecular weight of benzene also we can calculate. Let capital M be equal to molecular weight of benzene, which is equal to 78 grams. Here M is the molecular weight of benzene. M is the molecular weight of the benzene, and now the vapor pressure of solution is 0.845 bar. So let the PS represent the vapor pressure of solution, which is equal to 0.845 bar. And now he is asking us to calculate the molar mass of the solid substance. So let the small m be given by molar mass of the solid. So applying the Rolle's law, that is P naught minus PS divided by P naught is equal to, that is, XA, where XA is the mole fraction of the solute. If XA represents the mole fraction of solute, then the same expression you can write it as, that is, P naught minus PS divided by P naught is equal to, that is, number of moles of solute divided by number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. But if the solute is very dilute, but if the solution is very dilute and if there is a comparable mass, you can see that here the solute weight is just 0.5 grams when compared to 39 grams. 0.5 grams is very, very less, so therefore we can ignore the number of moles of solute in the denominator. So again we can take it as P naught minus PS divided by P naught is equal to NA divided by NB. This is because since number of moles of solute is very, very less compared to number of moles of solvent from the given data. So here we can calculate separately. Now here let NA be equal to small w by small m, weight of the solid divided by molecular weight of the solid. So here weight of the solid is 0.5 divided by small m, and number of moles of solvent is, that is, solvent is benzene, the weight of benzene we know it is 39, so that is capital W by capital M, which is equal to 39 divided by molecular weight of benzene is 78. So therefore we can take, this is 39 ones are 39 twos are 78, and we can substitute both these values in this expression. So here, therefore, because the number of moles of solute is very, very less compared to the number of moles of solvent, so just by substituting here, we can just take, now we already know that vapor pressure of the pure solvent is 0.85 bar and the vapor pressure of solution is 0.845 bar. So therefore 0.85 minus 0.845 divided by again the vapor pressure of the pure solvent is 0.85, which is equal to, so here we can substitute the number of moles of solute is equal to 0.5 divided by small m, again divided by, that is, number of moles of solvent is 1/2. So this is going to become 0.845. You take, this is 0 and this is also 0, so this is 4 and this is 1, this is 5, so this is 0.005, so approximately 0.005 divided by 0.85. If you take is equal to, this is going to become 0.5 by m into 2 by 1. So here if you take the simplification part, so this is going to become 0.005 divided by 0.85 is equal to, that is 1 by m. And if you take here m, if you take m is equal to 0.85 divided by 0.005, if you take this is 850 divided by 5, if you take 5 ones are 5 and 3, so this is going to become, that is 3 is the remainder, so 5 sevens are 35, so 0, so therefore this is going to become 170 grams is the molar mass of solid. Here m represents the molar mass of solid. So finally we got the molar mass of the solid. So if you go to the second part of the numerical in the properties of liquids, that is 18 grams of glucose is dissolved in 1 kg of water. At what temperature will water boil at 1.013 bar if the elevation in boiling point constant is equal to 0.12 Kelvin kg per mole? That means it is very clear that this problem is actually based on the colligative property, that is elevation in boiling point. So if the concept, that is the concept here which we have to tackle with the numerical, is that is elevation in boiling point is the concept which we are using. So here 18 grams of glucose is dissolved in 1 kg of solvent, means we can directly take small w is equal to 18 grams and gram molecular weight, 18 grams of glucose C6H12O6, molecular weight is equal to, molecular weight of glucose is equal to, that is 180 grams. Okay, fine. Then at what temperature the water will boil at 1.013 bar if Kb is equal to, that is 0.52 Kelvin kg per mole is the elevation in boiling point constant. Now we know very well that because it is elevation in boiling point, the formula which we are supposed to take is delta Tb is equal to Kb into, that is molality, where m is the molality here, m stands for molality. If it is molality, then if you expand delta Tb, because it is elevation in boiling point, always temperature of the solution is greater than the temperature of the pure solvent. That's because we can take P naught vapor pressure of the pure solvent is greater than the vapor pressure of solution, then you can take temperature of the solution is greater than temperature of the solvent. This is one concept which you have to keep it in mind in the case of elevation of boiling point. So therefore I am trying to expand delta Tb. If I am expanding delta Tb, then this is going to become Ts minus T naught is equal to, that is Kb into, I am also expanding the molality, that is small w divided by gram molecular weight into, that is, because the weight of solvent is given in, weight of the solvent is anyhow given in kg only, so therefore what I am going to do is, I am going to substitute here in the denominator, I am going to take weight of solvent in kg. So now here because he is asking us, already we are adding 18 grams of glucose, 18 grams of glucose is dissolved in 1 kg of water, means if 1 kg of water is solvent, if this 1 kg of water, if it is going to become the solvent, so 18 grams of glucose you are adding to this solvent. So once you are adding 18 grams of glucose, the solvent is going to become the solution. So at what temperature will the water boil at 1.013 bar? Means here we can take, let the temperature of the solution be unknown, but always the water will boil at, that is it's constant, and the water will always boil at 100 degrees centigrade. So converting the temperature, the water will boil at 100 degrees centigrade, converting this to Kelvin, this is going to become 373 Kelvin. So here the temperature of the water in the pure state, it is equal to 373, is equal to Kb value, we know elevation in boiling point constant value, already we know this is 0.52 into weight of the glucose is 18 grams, weight of the glucose is 18 grams, and the molecular weight of glucose, we know the molecular weight of glucose is 180, so 18 by 180 into weight of solvent of pure water is already 1 kg. So this is very simple to cancel, also simplify also, this is 10 zam. So temperature of the solution minus 373 is equal to this is 0.052. So therefore, temperature of the solution is equal to 373 plus 0.052. So temperature of the solution is going to become therefore equal to 373.052 Kelvin should be the answer. So therefore, the temperature at the temperature of 373.052 Kelvin, we can find that the water will start boiling at 1.013 bar when 18 grams of glucose is added. So this is the summary of the numerical, and this is the final answer which we got for the numerical. So here let us go to the next part of the numerical in the properties of liquids. That is, the question says that 45 grams of glycol is mixed with 600 grams of water. Calculate the depression in freezing point. That means here from the problem what we are able to understand is small w is equal to 45 grams of glycol. When you say glycol, this glycol molecular formula is CH2, the structural formula is CH2 single bond CH2 of OH. So this is going to be, that is, you can take C2H4O2. So the molecular weight outright you can calculate 12 to the each carbon atomic weight 12 grams. There are two carbons, so 12 to the 24 grams, 24. So this is 2 into carbon, which is equal to 24. This is 4 into hydrogen, each hydrogen atomic weight is 1, 1 into 4 is 4, so 0, 4. And there are 2 oxygens, 2 into oxygen, which is equal to 16 to the 32. So this is almost 10, and this is 60. So molecular weight is 60. So 60 grams is the molecular weight. Then in the meantime, and he has given the weight of water, that is, he has given the weight of water, the weight of solvent, that is 600 grams of H2O, 600 grams of H2O. And because he is asking us to calculate, the depression in freezing point, means indirectly he is asking us to calculate the delta TF. So what I am going to do here is, that is, simply I am going to take A to calculate the depression in freezing point. Delta TF is equal to KF into molality, if I am going to take, then delta TF is equal to KF value, already we know, that is 1.86 into molality, we have to expand. When you expand weight of the, that is, weight of the glycol is 45 grams, 45 divided by gram molecular weight of the glycol is 60 into, that is, weight of solvent is 1000 divided by, that is, expressed in grams, so 600. So this is going to be two zeros, and two zeros gets cancelled, 10, 10 also gets cancelled. So this is going to become, this step is going to become 1.86 into 45 divided by 36. If you take, so 9 1s are 9 4s are 36, 9 5s are 45. So I think you can just take this value approximately. Will it go in 4 tables? No, it won't go in 4 tables. So what I'm going to do here is that this value I'm just keeping as it is. The value I'm going to keep it as it is. And here what you're noticing is he is asking us to calculate the freezing point of the solution. So this is 1.86 into 5 means 186 into 5, that is 33, 8 5 is 40, 40 plus 3, 3, 4. Then you are going to get 4 plus 5, 9. 9 means decimal after 2 places, so 9.30 divided by 4. So 9.3 divided by 4. You keep it, keep the value as it is like this. In the meantime, so that means delta TF value we got 9.3 by 4 Kelvin we got here. So in the meantime, but we also know that delta TF will become equal to, that is, T naught minus TS, because it is freezing point of solution. In the freezing point of solution, because this problem is based on depression in freezing point, with respect to delta TF, in delta TF always, that is, T naught is greater than TS. That's because P naught is less than PS. This is a condition which we have to remember in the case of, that is, depression and freezing point. So if that is the case, delta TF roughly, if you take here, this is going to become 4 2s are 8, then this is going to become 4 3s are, so roughly I'm taking here 2.3 means, again, 1 is remainder, means 4 2 2.32, so roughly I'm going to take 2.3. so 2.3 is equal to, because he's asking us to calculate the freezing point of solution, all the liquid molecules start separating out in the form of solids at 0 degree centigrade. So 0 degree centigrade means I am taking here 273. So 273 minus TS, So TS is going to become, that is 273 minus 2.3. So 273 minus 2.3 is approximately 273.0 of 2.3. This is going to become, that is 2, and this is 7. So this is 270.2 Kelvin approximately we have to get the answer. So 270.7 Kelvin is the temperature of the, it is the temperature of the solution, is the final answer. So the next part of the discussion here in the numericals is, look at this problem, that is calculate the osmotic pressure in pascals exerted by a solution prepared by dissolving 1 gram of polymer of 1 gram of polymer of molar mass equal to 185 to 10 to the power of 3 in 450 ml of water at 37 degrees centigrade. The best thing is the concept involved here in this problem is the problem is based on osmotic pressure. If you go for osmotic pressure, its formula is pi, it is designated by pi, and mathematically osmotic pressure is actually given by C into R into T, where here C is the concentration of polymeric solution, and T is the temperature of solution, and R is the gas constant, R is the osmotic pressure constant. And here when you say concentration, this concentration can be expressed, if C is the concentration is given by N by V in liters, where N is the number of moles. So if you slightly expand this osmotic pressure formula, pi is equal to, therefore I can take N by V into R into T. Again you can expand the number of moles, that is small w by gram molecular weight into 1 by volume in liters into R into T. So from the, so I think this is the formula which we actually require for calculating this problem. So what we can do here is, like you know the weight of the polymer, that is equal to small w is equal to 1 gram of polymer. Molecular weight also we know, molecular weight of the polymer is 185 into 10 to the power of 3 units, 10 to the power of 3 units we have, and volume we have, volume of water, which is equal to, that is how much it is, volume of water 450 ml. So 450 ml means you convert into liters, this is going to become, that is 4.5, 450 by 1000, so this is going to become, that is 0.45 liters. Volume is 0.45 liters, and by temperature also it is given to us, temperature is equal to 37 degrees centigrade, you convert into Kelvin, this is 310 Kelvin. So here what we have to do here is just take this formula, substitute all the values one after the other. Osmotic pressure is equal to, that is weight is 1 gram divided by molecular weight is 185 into 10 to the power of 3 into that is gas constant, you can take 8.314 into 10 to the power of 3. Because it's asking us to calculate the osmotic pressure in pascals, we are supposed to take the R value is universal gas constant value is equal to 8.314 into 10 to the power of 3 pascal liter Kelvin per Kelvin per mole is the unit which we are supposed to take to solve this problem in terms of osmotic pressure which we are trying to calculate in pascals. So therefore that value we are substituting here, pascals into temperature is 310 Kelvin. Upon simplification you are going to get 30.96, that is pascal should be the final answer. Upon simplification 30.96 should be the answer, that is 10 to the power of 3 in the numerator and 10 to the power of 3 in the denominator, it gets cancelled, and it is going to be 8.314 into 310 divided by 185. Upon simplification, finally after the simplified value you are going to get 30.96 pascals will be the final answer for the osmotic pressure of the polymeric solution. So here the next part of the discussion in the numericals is, that is, the problem says like this: 2 grams of benzoic acid dissolved in 25 grams of benzene shows a depression in freezing point equal to 1.62 Kelvin. If the depression in freezing point constant, that is Kf, that is cryoscopic constant, is equal to 1.62 Kelvin kg per mole for benzene, what is the percentage of association of the acid if it forms a dimer in the solution? So when you are trying to read the problem, what you have to understand is, you have to catch this particular area. This is the area where you should be very careful in understanding the problem. He says that, what is the percentage of the association of the acid if it forms a dimer in the solution? That means this is a pucker problem based on the colligative properties. And here, if you are taking the electrolyte, that is benzoic acid, it is undergoing dimerization and it is also undergoing the association. So when benzoic acid is undergoing association, the first step one goes like this: take the benzoic acid, take two molecules of benzoic acid, and these two molecules of benzoic acids, they are trying to undergo, that is, association. They undergo association to give, that is, dimeric form. You know very well that when the given electrolyte is subjected to dimerization, here taken base, so these are the monomers of the benzoic acid. This is a dimer of the benzoic acid. So if that is the case, because he is already saying that that is percentage of association of the acid, but because he has already given the Kf value in the problem, he gave Kf of the benzoic acid, he has given 1.62, that is Kelvin, 1.62 Kelvin kg per mole he gave, and he gave the rate of the benzoic acid small w, which is equal to 2 grams, and I think we have to calculate the molecular weight of benzene. This m is the molecular weight of benzoic acid which is abnormal because it is undergoing the dimerization. Because of the undergoing of dimerization by the benzoic acid, there is a change in the molecular weight. The molecular weight suddenly gets doubled. So when the molecular weight is getting doubled, then the number of particles present in the benzoic acid actually decreases. That makes the benzoic acid molecule to undergo certain deviation from the molecular weight, and that deviation, that abnormality, is actually calculated in terms of Van 't Hoff factor. So we are going to apply the Van 't Hoff factor for the abnormality of the benzoic acid, no doubt. But in the meantime, we have to take the formula, that is, you can just take the formula, that is, 2 grams dissolved in 25 grams of 2 grams of benzoic acid dissolved in 25 grams of benzene. Means here the weight of solvent is also given, that is 25 grams of benzene weight is also given. So first of all, let us take delta T of F is equal to Kf into, that is, molality. I am expanding this delta Tf, which is equal to Kf into molality is small w by gram molecular weight into 1000 divided by weight of solvent in grams. So now delta Tf value, I think he gave already, that is, the depression in freezing point is equal to 1.62 Kelvin. That is 1.62 Kelvin if he is giving for benzene. Here the Kf value is just changed to 4.92 Kelvin kg per mole. Here also, I repeat, 4.92 Kelvin kg per mole, because you can't expect the depression in freezing point and the depression in freezing point constant to have the same values. That is why the values we are trying to change it. That's not a problem. So now if you go for the depression in freezing point, the value is 1.62. So 1.62 is equal to, depression in freezing point constant is almost 4.92 into weight of the benzoic acid is 2 grams. So I'm just taking the 2 grams here. And here, let the molecular weight of the benzoic acid be given by, that is, M into, let it be unknown, into 1000 divided by rate of solvent of the benzene is 25 grams. So this upon simplification, this is 25 ones are 25 40s are. So this is going to become molecular weight abnormality of the benzene is, this is 4.92. So this is 4.92 2 into 80 divided by 1.62. So this upon simplification, the value is going to become, this upon simplification, the value is going to become, so here this is approximately, the value is going to become 242 grams we are going to get finally. So this is the abnormal molecular mass. Abnormal molecular mass we got. Now apply the Van 't Hoff factor. Now normally what is the molecular weight of the benzoic acid? It is, there are actually 6 carbons, there are 7 carbons altogether. So 12 7s are 84. 12 into 7, 84 we have, and we have 6 hydrogens. So 6 into 12 7s are 84 means actually we have 7 carbons, sorry. 7 carbons means this here carbon 7. So there are 7 carbons, so each carbon atomic weight 12, 12 7s are 84. Then there are 6 hydrogens, here the atomic weight is 6, and we have 2 oxygens, 2 into oxygen, which is equal to 32. So altogether this is going to become, this is 122. 122 is the molecular weight. So therefore now, including the Van 't Hoff factor, go for the Van 't Hoff factor, that is calculation of the Van 't Hoff factor if you take. So therefore this is step 1, take this as step 1 and take this as step 2. In step 2, what I am doing here is Van 't Hoff factor is equal to, that is molecular mass abnormal molecular mass, that is normal molecular mass divided by actual molecular mass. So here we got, that is normal molecular mass is around 122 divided by abnormal molecular mass we are going to get, that is it is 140, this we are going to get here as 142 grams approximately we are going to get. So 142 grams we are going to get. So after calculations you are going to get 0.504 is the approximate value we are going to get for the Van 't Hoff factor. After simplification we are going to get 0.504. So I repeat, here the total abnormal molecular mass is 242 grams. So that abnormal molecular mass you can take it in terms of 242 here, and this upon simplification you are going to get around 0.504. So here if you go to the step 3, in step 3 now you can take alpha is equal to, that is alpha is equal to 1 minus I divided by 1 minus 1 by n. This is the formula which we use for calculating the degree of association of the benzoic acid. So here interestingly already we know the I value, which is equal to 0.504. So alpha is equal to, that is the I value you can substitute here. Here because the benzoic acid is getting dimerized, the N value is going to become equal to 2. So therefore 1 minus 0.504 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2. So this is going to become, this is 0.504 means 1.00.504 if you take. So this is going to become 6, and this is 9, and so if this is 9 then this is going to become 0.496. So 0.496 if you take, so this is going to become 0.496 divided by 1 by 2, which is equal to 0.496 into 2. So alpha is equal to, this is nothing but, that is 12, this is 1, 9 to 18, 9, again we are going to get 189. So 0.992 is the alpha. Then alpha percentage is equal to, that is multiplied with 100, so 99.2% is the amount of benzoic acid which has been associated. the benzoic acid, percentage of benzoic acid associated associated